Hey everyone, my name is Andy Cummins. I'm a strategic account manager here at Inntopia, and I've got Chris Eaton with me. Chris, do you want to just give a quick intro to your role and what you do here at Inntopia?
Yeah. Chris Eaton, hi everyone. I'm director of product and customer success. And Andy and I are super excited to walk you through some of the new features that live in the Commerce Portal. So we're going to work on that today and walk you through those things. And we're super excited to have you listen and follow along.
Okay, everyone, here is a view that you've likely seen if you've logged into our CRS system in the last few months. This is our new and exciting Commerce Portal. What you'll see in here is a bunch of different new menus and access to your traditional CRS view. And now you additionally have an option to see the RMS accounts that you have access to. So we're very excited about this sort of a unifying view and access to a lot of existing tools and new tools that we'd like to highlight in this clip today. The first one, and kind of the most obvious, is you can see from this welcome screen, you have your links to the central reservation system and the RMS link. These will take you to the views that you're most used to. If you click in through to the CRS, this will take you to the view that you used to have when you log in. And then the same thing with the RMS. So it'll give you the RMS screens that you're most used to. But what we think is probably the most exciting about this is that you're going to have some new access to this quick links menu, which will have some new reporting tools, some new troubleshooting tools, and some new ways to help you manage the system in general. And then the same thing here with the tools report. We'll see some additional options that don't necessarily exist in the quick links menu. The idea behind this portal is that we're going to continue to add functionality to it. We'll increase the links behind reports, behind tools, and behind the quick links with new and improved products so that you can more easily access the things that you're most likely to use. Is there anything else you'd like to add on this one, Chris?
No, I just think it's really exciting, you know, to be updating this infrastructure, having a better place where we're going to slowly move out some of those items that you traditionally see in the CRS. We're going to make enhancements in here. And this is really where we want people to start, you know, with the system, is coming into the Commerce Portal so they can see everything. User permissions are going to go across. So you're going to be able to, you know, like Andy said, if you've got access to a number of RMS accounts, it's a great place to start. So you can get right in there. When you log into this, it's still going to have that two-factor or multi-factor authentication that we have both in the RMS and the CRS. And yeah, we're really excited about building this out, and the team's done a fantastic job of bringing some of those older tools into a newer infrastructure architecture to benefit you guys.
Okay, for this next feature, we've made some big improvements to how we can manage usernames within the system. And then we've also improved some of the visibility based on user permissions for those usernames. So when you're in the home screen for the Commerce Portal, you'll see that you'll have access to the user management link here within Quick Links. You'll also see it available in the tools menu. And if you happen to be within the CRS itself in the traditional view, you'll be able to access this new menu from the users tab within the CRS. Keep in mind that we did do some improvements around what tools and what visibility is available to you based on the user permissions that your account has. So if you don't happen to see some of these things, speak with your Inntopia admin to see if you need access to these options. So clicking into it, you'll see that this is a new view, much more expanded view than the traditional view, which was pretty condensed to one page. Now you can see, you know, everything sort of more in one screen, and it's just a bit more user-friendly. Starting from the top, you'll see that the option to manage by sales channel is a lot more obvious. In the past, this dropdown lived kind of in a small dropdown on the right-hand side of the screen and wasn't necessarily clear who you were editing for. So now we've made it front and center. When you expand that, you can see, you know, which options and which users you're applying to which sales channel. The next most new exciting feature is that if you need to create a new user for a sales channel, this can be done now in one step rather than two. By clicking on the create new user, you'll see your traditional create user ID, password, you know, assign first, last name, email, contact information, and then you'll also be able to select some predefined user roles, which we can get into later in the video. But then once all that is completed, you can add user and that'll apply it to this particular sales channel. In the past, it was a two-step process. You would create the user and then you'd have to go and select that user and add them to the sales channel. So we've simplified that and made it a little bit more straightforward. Once that user is created, you'll then see them in this current users listing. It's not highlighted in this particular account because we don't have very many demos, but if you did have quite a few users for your sales channel, this will be a scrollable menu as well. So you'll be able to kind of see everybody that's included. But then with the user roles that we defined here, you'll see that for some of these, is we've already selected them as admin, so they'll have access to everything. But for things like reservation agent or for accounting, we'll limit access to the different areas of the system to make sure that they only have access to the items that are pertinent to their role. These can be edited. You know, if the predefined user roles don't necessarily make sense for the user, so it's as simple as, you know, selecting or deselecting what options the user should have, and then be sure to save the work. If for some reason you come in and edit and you're in the wrong username, any changes that you make, if you decide that you want to remove those, you can simply click the X and it will revert back to what was saved previously. The add user button is the same thing. This is similar to what we had in the past. If you've got an existing username, if somebody's got access to a different sales channel, or if they're coming from a different company and they've got access to Inntopia already, you can quickly add them to this sales channel as well and assign their user permissions. And finally, the probably most exciting improvement for this screen is that we can now remove users. This was functionality that didn't necessarily exist previously. So for resorts and for our partners that see some turnover with people that need to access Inntopia, we can now clean up those lists and make it so that only the relevant users are listed here. And this can be done by clicking on the trash can icon for the user. It'll give you the pop-up to make sure that you do want to actually remove this user. And in my case, I don't want to remove this user, so I won't. But then if you did, they would be pulled off the list and it'd be a little bit easier to manage and make sure that the users in your system have the access that they need. So this is, again, new improvement, exciting new feature and functionality that works for user management. We hope that you find it as convenient as we do. And if you'd like to find out more about the different user privileges and the functions within those privileges, you can always access the Inntopia Help article available via the partner dashboard. Okay, for this next clip, we'd like to show some really exciting new functionality that a lot of partners have been asking for quite some time. It's the ability to fully remove both products and promotions from the list view within the CRS and the RMS supplier accounts. We'll start with promotions by navigating to the promotions tab, where you'll see within your sales channel the list of active and inactive. If you happen to click the archive button, this functionality will work for both active promos and promotions that have expired. the functionality to archive these features is not going away. So if you do let your promotion expire, you will continue to see this folder icon letting you know that this is no longer an active promotion because the stay dates have elapsed. So if you prefer to manage your promotions that way, that continues to be an option. However, with some of our long-term partners, this list is now several hundred lines long and it can be a little unruly to manage. So now we've given our partners the option to fully remove these from the system. The way to do that is actually very, very simple. You can just navigate to the options list and you'll see at the very bottom of the option there, there's the option to remove. You'll get the embedded message there saying that you will no longer be able to access this. If that's the case, go ahead and click OK. I'm going to not do that just so that we can keep this available in our demo account if we need it. This action is permanent. So if you do remove it, we cannot get it back. So that's why I can exercise extra caution with this one. So just if you are going to fully remove a promotion, please be absolutely sure you won't be using it again or be prepared to rebuild it from the beginning. But once you do take a look at this and you have some access, you're going to be able to clean your list hopefully way down so that you're really only looking at maybe the season's active promotions and the promotions maybe from last season that you might still want to reuse for the future. Very, very similar functionality to the promotions removal is what you'll see here in the RMS account. The same kind of idea with products. Here you'll see a list of active and, in this case, inactive products as well. This functionality, again, exists for both products that are active and inactive. So you can go back and clean up those old products from past seasons as well. Similar to the promotions, you'll see it within the settings option. It's not at the bottom in this case, it's in the middle. But you'll see the option to remove, and it's the same thing. You'll get the pop-up that asks if you want to fully remove this product. Please be sure to make sure that this is a product you're no longer using because it is permanent and you won't be able to access it again. Also similar to the promotions, we do have the concept of the deactivation of the product that didn't go away. So if you do just want to remove the product, you have the activate and deactivate. So in this case, I'm looking at a deactivated product. If I go into and look at an activated project, I'll have the deactivate button. So if you prefer to manage it and you're used to managing that way, that's still available to you. But if you do want to clean up your list, you do now have this remove button as well. So this is functionality that I know has been waiting for a long time and hope you're as excited about it as we are. If you have any other questions about it, feel free to look at the help article for more information about managing your promotions and products. All right, for this clip, we would like to show you the improvements that we've made to the search options screen that previously existed within the CRS, but you can now access via the Commerce portal. So to get it from this screen, you'll see that it's an option in the tools dropdown. In my case, it's at the very bottom of the list. You'll also be able to access where you're traditionally used to finding it with the search options tab within the CRS itself. So let's jump into it and you'll see that it's a significantly different view than what existed in the past. Before, when you clicked into this within the CRS, you'd see an expanded version of all the different destination search options, the amenities, and all these things. So right off the bat, you can see that the view is much easier because now we can expand and collapse these menus so you know exactly what type of search option you're looking for.
Andy, I think the most exciting thing that I love about this screen is the fact that you can search for a search option and filter by a specific one, because I've spent way too many hours going through there, looking through the long list that's in the old CRS to select a specific one. So this is, it's super exciting to have this search option.
Yeah, that's right, Chris. And you can see that I just typed in hot tub when I had all of those previous menus collapsed. You can see part of that search is actually locating it within the list of different amenity types and then pulling it out so that you know exactly, you know, what section to go to, and then also having the selections available themselves. I think the other, actually a number of exciting improvements with this is that you can also manage by sales channel a little bit more, obviously. In the past, this menu was off to the kind of the right-hand side and it was a bit smaller and it wasn't necessarily clear that you were working on a specific sales channel. So now again, we've made that front and center and just makes it a bit more obvious for what we're looking for. Just as a quick reminder of what these options are, is that these are things that will fall into the Agentopia search screen for your call center agents so that they can more quickly narrow down availability based on the customer's preferred amenity types, locations, you know, number of different options, you know, types of, you know, lodging, whether it's condo or hotel. Obviously, in the case that I've got here in front of us, you know, if they prefer to have, you know, access to a hot tub, washer and dryer, deck, grill, those types of things. So this is going to be useful for your agents because they'll be able to pre-select these in their search. But then they'll also display on the e-com, at least for the native Inntopia version of e-com, for guests to pre-select for themselves. So that's what we're managing here. But this screen is just a new and improved version of that. And I think the one other piece that's worth mentioning here is that when we do select and unselect any of these features, it now automatically saves the work. In the past, you could select and unselect a variety of different options for a given sales channel, but it didn't save until you scroll to the very, very bottom of the page. And again, with, you know, all these expanded menus, you had to sometimes scroll, you know, quite far down the page to get to the save button. So now just by clicking and unclicking, this automatically updates as well.
Yeah, I can tell you how many times I definitely selected, unselected, and then moved on from that page without actually hitting the save button. So pretty awesome to have that in there.
So again, another quality of life improvement that we've made towards the overall functionality of the system. As always, if you have any questions about how search options work or how to best manage them with your suppliers and your third-party suppliers, feel free to access the help article available through the partner dashboard.
Yeah, and I think it's important to note too, you know, that the search options are only there if the supplier accounts are filled out well at that, you know, property level, specific rooms, the amenities there, unit amenities. Those things actually need to be filled out in the supplier accounts for you to be able to actually filter on those. So just, yeah, if you're doing some of this and it's not filtering the way that you want, you know, you can search into those supplier accounts, make sure that it's set up the way that it should be. And some of you might be asking about, you know, thinking about destinations. We have some info about destinations in the help article. It's really for some of our partners that sell multiple destinations, sort of, you know, different areas, maybe Colorado and Vermont or something like that. But if you need more info, go to the help center. The help articles are amazing. So definitely go there to find out more.
All right. For our next improvement from the commerce portal, we'd like to show you the new view to manage your marketing sources. And just as a quick primer for what marketing sources are, you'll see that when you start a new session for Agentopia from within the CRS, the first action that's required is for the user to select a source. That's what we're managing here, is making it an easier view and more editable view, making sure that those sources are something that are worthwhile and trackable for your marketing efforts to know, you know, where guests are coming from. So as is the case with everything in the commerce portal, you can access it now through the tools drop-down menu. You can see that there's the source management option. If you happen to be in the CRS and you want to make changes to this, you'll also be able to access this new menu from the sources tab that existed previously in the CRS, but it's going to default to this new view as well. So you'll see that it's a much larger view, a much easier view to take in from the past. It also sort of makes it a little bit more linear in terms of what we'd like to edit and how you'd like to edit it. Just as a kind of a reminder of how sources work in Inntopia, we've got the idea of a source supercategory. More often than not, you've really only got one super source, which is typically the name of the sales channel itself. In some unique circumstances, we will have some additional ones, but even in our demo account here, we've really just got this one super source, and that's just an additional layer of classification that we use in Inntopia. So the reality is where we want to focus is this, the create new source category and create new source itself. So the idea behind the source category is that that's sort of like a folder type account so that you can sort of group like items together. The example I typically use is the idea of a trade show. So you can say, I want my source category to be trade show. And then from within that, you create a source that says, you know, ski show, golf show, consumer show, those types of things. And that way you can sort of see all those items listed together in that dropdown when you're trying to start a new session with Inntopia. So the navigation of this is actually quite easy. If you want to create a new test category, you just click on the new option, and you can say, I'll just say new source category for our purposes. And then I'm not sure I want to add it. Yes. And then you'll be able to see at the bottom of the list, now we've got this new source category. Same idea behind create new source. I'll say new source type, just simple, and then I'll actually assign it to that new source category folder. And we'll follow through and make sure that we add it. And you'll now see that that's available as an option within that source category and as a source type. And you can add as many sources as you'd like here, or you can have standalone. So just if you do want to create a new source, make sure that you have a source category. And realistically, those two can be the same things. Or you can just have the single source category, and then that can be the option to choose from as well. There is the idea of default categories that come with every Inntopia account. So things like phone, email, internet, walk-in, these types of things. If these are categories you don't typically use, or if you're not looking to edit them, you can easily remove them from this view, and then you can see the items that you've just created specifically to your sales channel. The other thing that's nice about this new menu is that for these existing types of sales category and sources, you will now be able to edit those a bit more straightforwardly than you could in the past. So you can literally just click in and make an adjustment. You can clear them out, and if you would like, you can save that work. And then if you do make an adjustment to a category that you were not necessarily trying to edit, if you just X out of it, it doesn't save the work. So that's good. And then the final improvement that we see from the screen now is the ability to easily delete unused source category or unused source types. So just as a demonstration, I'll remove the work that I've done in this, and you'll see that you get the pop-up to remove the source, and you can click yes. And the same thing with this category level as well. You can also delete, but if you choose not to, it will remain. So I'll go ahead and clear this out. We've always got more information about sources, the best practices around source management, and how to make sure that your agents are selecting, and if necessarily needing to edit for a given Inntopia session. So if you need additional information, you can find more from the partner dashboard through our ever-growing library of help articles.
Yeah, and in there too, it notes that if you want to run some reports that show source categories, the three main reports that it works with are the comprehensive sales report, the itinerary summary, in the same day sales report. So those are the places that we display those source categories when you're doing that stuff. So you can test it there. You can go in, you can look and see. A number of our partners have used sources pretty extensively. So if you want some best practices, we can put you in contact with some of our partners that have done that.
All right. And with our final clip of the Commerce Portal improvements and tools, we'd like to highlight what we now call the Promotion Inspector. The idea behind this tool is it's a quick way to be able to see all the attributes and items that are included in a promotion from one screen, and to help you easily troubleshoot if there are any issues with the build of that promotion. This is an improvement over what you'd see from the CRS or from within the RMS building this, because a lot of these different features live in different screens and different pop-ups from within the builder itself. And now we've created a place for you to be able to see it all in one area, so you can get a quick overview of what's available. As always, the access to this tool can be found in the quick links menu that I just clicked on, and also from the tools drop down as the first option. When you land on this page, you'll see the different navigation options that are available, starting with the sales channel that it might be applicable to. So you can search to any of those that you have access to. You can also search by promotion ID. Promotion ID can be found within the promotion builder next to the name of the promotion itself, with the kind of a multi-digit code within parentheses. We've also improved this from the initial version, is that for any active promotions that you have within that sales channel, you can quickly click into those, but then you can also search for inactive as well. So just quick, easy way to pull that up if you're working on something that you were building pretty recently. But once you click into this stay, in this case, the stay and pay package, what you'll see is a number of different options. Starting on the left here, we'll highlight some of the basic information about the package. So things about what supplier this is coming from, so where the inventory and availability is coming from, if you've added a promotion code so that it's trackable with your PMS. The idea behind active dates and booking dates is that, you know, this will be essentially what we consider stay dates. If you don't have an advanced book window, this will also act as your booking dates as well. So continuing down, you'll see some of the restrictions types, the display types, how the discounts are set. Something that I find incredibly useful there is also being able to see what resellers the promotion is published to. In the past, you'd have to kind of go into a number of different menus to see this, and now it's all available here exactly in one spot. Over on the right-hand side, you'll see that there's a bit more of an inspector given the dates and the guest count, so you can test to see how different portions of the promotion will display given a given search date, and all of these menus are expandable, so you'll be able to kind of get an idea of what's available for any given time period. So we're recording this at the end of June. I'll just shift it over to a couple more days to see what's available. We can refresh and we can expand the menu to see what's available for this given state age for a search type of two adults. What's also pretty handy about this is if you have multiple suppliers participating in this promotion, you'll be able to see the unit that the supplier is offering, but then also the supplier itself, and then they are grouped by the different suppliers. So if you're trying to troubleshoot why something is not showing up for a given supplier, you can quickly come in, check to see that they've got availability loaded for these dates, and if not, then you can pretty quickly say that that's the reason that they're not displaying. The other thing is that you can also see the discount that is being applied to this. So that's particularly handy for your lodging suppliers. If we expand some of these other lodging options, you'll also see what's available for the different product types that are out there. And so in this case, we're using some golf products to display. And so you'll see that they'll have access to the different tee times and the different courses, similar to the lodging, just kind of a breakdown of these different things. So again, just a really quick and easy way to see what is included in a given promotion, to understand, you know, how those discounts are being applied, where they're being published to, and then understanding what availability components might be impacting whether or not they're visible within Inntopia or online. We do have more information about Promotion Inspector in our help articles, which you can access through the partner dashboard. And then obviously, if there's any questions, reach out to our support lines or to your account manager.